Hello, welcome to LADA Life. I'm Linnea May Huxford, and today I'm going to talk about something that I didn't have to think about for the first 35 years of my life, which is insulin syringes and insulin needles and how to discard insulin needles, syringes safely so that nobody gets hurt with these sharp materials. That's why they call them sharps. They're sharps. They're potentially dangerous things. You do not want to just throw out a used insulin syringe into your garbage because it could hurt somebody. And it's also probably against the law. It's very dangerous. So you need to make sure you dispose of sharps properly. So I'm going to give a little overview of how my insulin journey has been and talk about what I do to dispose of my insulin sharps safely. When I was first prescribed insulin, I was prescribed it in a vial by my primary care physician, and she also prescribed syringes, insulin syringes, which you do need if you're going to be dosing from a vial. Insulin syringes come in many different sizes, and my doctor actually prescribed one that was too big. She prescribed ones that could hold 100 units, but I was only dosing like 3 units, so it was very difficult to dose like 3 units out of a syringe that could hold 100. Now this syringe is more appropriately size because this one only holds 30 units, so I can dose a few units out of this one. When I later saw an endocrinologist, she quickly spotted the error and prescribed syringes that were the correct size for the amount of insulin I needed to dose. I also started using insulin pens instead of insulin syringes, which are way more convenient. Insulin pen, a lot of people who take insulin need both short-acting insulin and long-acting insulin. One thing to be really careful about is make sure that you don't accidentally mistake one for the other, because usually the dose that you take for long-acting insulin is much different from the dose for the short-acting insulin, and they last a very different time period. So make sure you keep these insulins in 2 different places, or maybe you want to decorate one of your insulin pens so it really stands out. This is the short-acting insulin, not the long-acting insulin, and be very careful when you're dosing that you're dosing the correct amount of the correct type of insulin. Insulin pens are reusable. They have a bunch of insulin in them, so they don't come with a needle on the top there. You have to get pen needles, a box of pen needles, which will usually be prescribed separately, and you screw on the pen needle to the top of the insulin pen. So whether you're using insulin pens or insulin syringes, you have a needle on the tip of it that you need to dispose it safely. The most amazing discovery when I was using insulin pens and insulin syringes was this needle clipper here. I'll link to it in the description, but suddenly I didn't have to have a big container to put all my sharps in there, like my used insulin syringes. I could cut off the needle tip of the insulin syringe, and that is stored in here, and there's like, it'll hold like 2,000 insulin syringe, insulin needles, the tips of the needles only, and that's the dangerous part, so it will safely store it in here, and it's labeled biohazard, and then the plastic part you can discard because there's nothing sharp on it. So that was a great discovery. I wish somebody had told me about that before. So that's the easiest way really of discarding needles if you are using insulin pens or insulin syringes. Otherwise, you could get a sharps container and put the whole insulin syringe into the sharps container. Or you can also use an empty plastic juice bottle or something that is a plastic container that has a lid on it. Which brings me to this big thing, which you might have been wondering, what is this thing? So now I use an insulin pump, and all these things in this container are the injector thing for the infusion set. So the infusion set is a little plastic piece that goes right under my skin, and that's where the insulin from the insulin pump goes into my body. And this is the tool for injecting that infusion set on my body. And there's a needle inside of these plastic things. It's a pretty simple process as far as application. There's lots of videos online that will show you how that works. However, there's a needle in there and you can't just throw it out, and it's pretty large. So I got these peanut butter pretzels container and I've been saving them up, and my pharmacy will take this and will discard of it properly. The only problem here is these pretzels are actually pretty tasty and they're not exactly low carbohydrates. 15 grams for one serving, which is 8 pretzels, 4 grams of protein. At least there's protein. But yeah, this is a good treat. Kind of funny to buy this for the container, but it does work out. So I hope that gives you some ideas. I wonder what other questions you have. I've been saving up all my insulin vials here. I have a box of them, maybe to do some artwork, some crafts with it. So that's a little bit about some of the things you have to think about when you're dosing insulin with an insulin syringe or an insulin pump. All these things have something that is sharp too, and it's considered sharps, and you have to dispose of it properly. Let me know what questions you have. Please like this video if it was helpful. Subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future LADA Life podcasts here on YouTube. My shirt is from T1 International, a nonprofit organization working to make insulin affordable for all. Banting, Best, Kalip, and McLeod, those were the scientists who are credited with the discovery of insulin. Check out the description for a link to the T1 International t-shirt shop so you can support them too and get a really cool shirt. The history of insulin is amazing. So many things to be grateful for. Thank you. Check out my free ebook, What They Don't Tell You About Insulin Pumps, But I Will. What you really need to know before starting. How to navigate the ups and downs of pump life. Lessons they don't always teach you in training. Personal stories, hard-won wisdom, and honest advice. Get your free copy today at insulinpumplife.com or scan the QR code pictured here. When I was diagnosed with LADA diabetes, my endocrinologist said I was a good candidate for an insulin pump. At the time, I had no idea what an insulin pump was, and it just felt very scary. Fast forward many years, and now I use an insulin pump, and it's been a very good decision. Insulin pumps have become very advanced, and it makes my life easier. However, it's not all rainbows, so definitely if you're thinking about an insulin pump or want to know more about an insulin pump, check out my free ebook on my website, insulinpumplife.com.